Morning folks, Israel here with Austin Boats and Motors. Today I'm going to be showing you this 2020 Ranger Z520L Ranger Cup equipped. This one's going to have a white top cap with a black hull bottom. It's also going to have white and black to match the interior with a gray carpet. So we've got our tongue up here, which folds back. When the tongue is folded back, the length on the boat is going to be 23 feet and 9 inches. That's with the motor trimmed down and the tongue folded back. So perfect if you need to put it in a garage, as long as you've got 24 or 25 feet of room in there. You should have plenty of room to fit this in there. This is going to come with a Minn Kota Ultrex iPilot up there at the bow. We'll get into that in here in just a moment. On the outside of the boat, this one has fiberglass fenders on it with step-ups, three different locations there. And it's got the 17-inch Challenger wheels. Really gives this boat a good look when it's on its trailer, when you're trailering it to and from the water. Moving towards the back of the boat, we've got 2 8-foot power pole blades. They're mounted to the jack plate. And then it's going to be powered by this Mercury 250 Pro XS. It's got a 3-blade stainless steel prop. Moving towards the transom of the boat, you can see here we've got our through-hole plug for our battery charger. And then we've also got our battery gauge letting us know where our batteries are at. Right here we've got our remote drain plug. That way you don't have to crawl underneath the boat to put the drain plug in. These nice chrome finished plates right here to help you get in and out of the boat. You can hold on to these to pull up. Moving into the boat here towards the stern, I'll show you one of these compartments here. This is where your batteries are going to be. So you've got your battery switch right here. It's off right now. You've got on, run, jump start, and battery 2 only. Right here is where your battery charger is going to be. It's going to show you the battery percentage charged for each battery. So right there you have 2 trolling motor batteries, another one over here, and then the green top is going to be your starting battery. Oh, one more thing, I forgot about that. This does have a spot for you to keep an extra prop on hand. That's pretty nice, especially if you're going to be tournament fishing. You never know when you might need another prop. Moving over to the side, you have a pretty big storage compartment here. It's all fiberglass with a nice rubber insert on the bottom. There's some goodies from Ranger that they send with their boats for all their customers. It's got some cleaning supplies, fuel stabilizer, and then tucked up in there, I don't know if you can see or not, but there's a fire extinguisher that comes standard with the boat. So moving up here, we've got our 2 Livewell lids. It's nice that they're separated. We've got our oxygenator right there with the light towards the left of it. Same thing over here. And there's this divider. Very nice. This boat is going to be equipped with the Venturi Livewell air and pump out system. So this boat is tournament ready. We have a step down right here that has some nice non-skid traction on there. And this is going to be your glove box area. It's got a power outlet right there, 12 volt. All right. So moving up here, we've got our helm area. We'll go ahead and take a sit down. So over here, you've got your trim gauges, fuel, speed, water PSI right here. And that's gonna be your engine link for your Mercury. It's gonna tell you engine info. Up here on the console, we've got an HDS 12. You have a trim lever right here. And then over here is going to be your wireless system, which is going to control your start and stop, all your functions of the boat, so your manual bilge, your auto bilge, some accessory switches in here. This is going to be to get your storage compartments to air out. There's a few others on there too, like your oxygen keeper. Right up here we've got our pump out, recirculate and empty for your live well. Got your throttle. And then over here for the passenger, you have your glove box.
Can you send me a picture of that, Ryan?
This has got a 12 volt and a USB. Nice big compartment. All of these do lock, so all of your storage compartments and your glove box can be able to lock. So when you're not using this thing, maybe you want to stop for a bite to eat, you can lock up all your stuff. Don't have to worry about nobody getting into your boat. Up here, we've got another little bait well that's insulated. It's used to step up in the boat. Something cool that Ranger does with most of their boats like this is they include a measuring stick there for measuring your catches. Tucks away nice and neat so it's not in your way. Here in the center, I'm gonna go ahead and flip it up. This is gonna be your center rod box. This is a pretty cool little area of the boat. Opens up nice and big. Right here you've got slot for 10 rods, and your center rod box is gonna be able to hold 8-foot poles. As you can see on each side, there's vents, so all of these compartments are linked together. There's a switch on that control panel at the helm where you hit that, and let's say you have some wet poles in here, wet life jackets, wet whatever it is, you know, you got some condensation or moisture in your boxes, you hit that switch and it circulates all the air out of there, gets that moisture out, so you're not getting any mold or mildew inside your compartments. Now moving here to the port side rod locker. Got a spot for a bunch more rods. These are gonna be 8'6". So moving over to this side, got another nice fiberglass box. This would be good to hold tackle. Same thing with this. You can put life jackets in here, whatever else you may need out there on the water. So up here on the deck, you've got two boat buckles for your rods. So you can lay your rods out back here. It's got a nice little padded area for them to lay down. That way you can strap them to the deck if you need. You want to keep them easily accessible and not have them in the locker. So here's our Minn Kota Ultrex iPilot. It's going to be 112-pound thrust. It's a 36-volt trolling motor. It's going to come with a remote. I have a recessed foot pedal here. Keep it anchored down, not in the way, not floating around, you know. And then we have another HDS-12 up here at the bow. Right up here you can see you've got your up and down for your trim, nav and anchor, live well 1 and 2, your accessory switch, and then your interior lights button. So if you're up here, you don't really have to leave the bow of the boat for fishing. You can trim that motor up when you start getting into shallower water and don't have to worry about dragging your skeg on the ground. That's pretty much it for this Ranger Z520. Ranger Cup equipped. It's a very beautiful boat. Well, folks, if y'all have any more questions or would like more information about this boat, give us a call at 512-263-2811 or check us out online at austinboats.com. Thank you for watching.